Uganda is currently one of the biggest refugee hosting countries on the continent, hosting over 1.5 million refugees in various settlements across the country. Although many of the refugees have access to quality education, they are, however, unfortunate in terms of employment. Papi, a Congolese refugee and the director of Refugee Talent Group, confesses that despite living in Uganda for over a decade, his efforts to secure a job have been futile.
As a refugee, the first challenge I can say that identity of being a refugee, that's profile. People, they don't look your require your skills. No, they just focus on the refugees. But I do believe people, they have requirements. People, they have education background. People, they have degrees in the communities. But it's very hard for them to get a job.
He explains that even when he went ahead to open his own organization where he employs fellow refugees and even nationals, things have not been easy.
When you open an organization, is it easy for you to onboard also communities, nationals, mean national? But it's very hard you as a refugee going and look for job and to get job for somewhere for the also community, which is very bad. If we need to talk about social inclusion, it must start by acting. You get, you can even see on the different refugee organization or different international organization, there is not a refugee inside.
Hilda Namakula, the program's manager at Window International Uganda, reveals that there is a need to also improve employment policies to enable refugees engage in productive work.
They relax the work permit policy. First of all, we heard that some of them can strive and pay for the work permit, but they don't have the knowledge on how to access it, for example. They don't have the backing of the employers to get it, for example. Most employers have not been sensitized on this issue of work permits. Most of them are reluctant to take up refugees because of the work permit.
The Ministry of Internal Affairs charges $400, that is approximately 1.5 million shillings, for a work permit every year. Namakula believes this fee is too high for refugees and she recommends a waiver or even a total elimination of this requirement.
If we are saying we are doing an integration, it should be a meaningful kind of integration where someone has the right to work and they're actually working. Let's not just keep it in a document, say refugees have the right to work, but then on the other hand, it's hard for them to access employment given the different policies in place.
It is true, I cannot say no. But I think it's not only them, because even many Ugandans are volunteering in places of work because they have failed. Others have moved on the streets for over 3 years and they have failed to get employed.
According to a report released by the Window International Uganda, an education partner to the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees, a huge number of refugees have acquired quality and tertiary education with the help of scholarship obtained from the humanitarian organizations and very few of the hand-landed employment. Even those that have opted for self-employment say the enterprises are marginalized. Report by Rachel Nachwala for the news.